Interlocking towers across America are succumbing to new technology. As a result, they're being taken out of service and in many cases demolished at an alarming rate. Some continue to exist, but for how long? We know it's only a matter of time. The clock is ticking louder now and at a more pronounced rate. Towers are symbols of another era, a time we'd like to freeze forever. Like other icons from earlier days of railroading, the towers too shall fall. Gone are active passenger stations located in nearly every small town. Gone are crossing shanties, water tanks, coaling towers, roundhouses, and more. The list goes on and on. We're fortunate to have had the opportunity to coexist with many of our cherished icons well after their useful purpose had expired. But now it's time to say goodbye to the towers, a symbol of joys experienced and of our time invested down by the tracks. But the saddest part of this farewell is to say goodbye to the tower operators. They were a source of information to many a rail fan, a human interface with the railroad that has no replacement. Many operators were friends, mentors, and many were actually rail fans themselves. As we look at the location where Sandpatch Tower once stood, we're reminded of how quickly things can change. Picking through the rubble, an artifact is pulled from the debris. It's nothing but a simple piece of paper, but it contains magic, capable of transporting our emotions back to those not too distant golden days. Reality takes hold, stilling mental images from the past. The tower really is gone, and it's not going to reappear, ever. It's gone.
First off, you have to be here. That's the first thing. So you can't go anywhere. Even if you don't have any train, you can't go anywhere. Because this is your ship. This is your tour of duty, where you're supposed to be for 8 hours or 12 hours or 16 hours or whatever it is. Okay, so when you come prepared. That's why everybody carries on the railroad. If you notice, we all have a bag. We all carry it. Everybody's got a grip. If the refrigerator doesn't work or the electricity goes out, or, so you make sure you have a pack of crackers. You make sure you have something to drink. You know, this isn't something that, you never know what's going to happen when you get here. So you got to be prepared for anything. And if it snows, we've all been out here 30 hours, 35 hours, 36 hours. So you never know what's going to happen, especially when it gets to be winter. So you come prepared for anything. You carry clean clothes, you always have clean underwear. You carry everything you need in your vehicle because you just never know. 36 hours, it comes up. We were snowed in and nobody could get in and nobody could get out. And finally, they got Amtrak out. And Amtrak threw me off a tuna fish sandwich. And even after 2 days, you know what a tuna fish sandwich tasted like? A filet mignon. It was pretty good. Not to this day, I don't want a tuna sandwich, and I never want to see another tuna sandwich. But that day, it was pretty good. This is called Station Train Movement Record. And this is a record of every train. And a train is an engine, or engines, with or without cars, that's a train. Okay, so even a helper engine is a train. So this is the we keep a record of what time they go by me. I keep a record of what time they go by the tower on either side of me, because that's my block. All right, so you keep track of them in your block. And that's only because of the rules. The rules say that, like, if I want to put another train in that block, you've got to know where the train ahead is. I mean, it's some government rules. You know what I mean? You know how that can be. So that's what this is. That's just a record. And I'll know when a train is getting close because my board will light up. The train will be on the circuit. And then the dispatcher will give me instructions as to what to do with it. The computer system makes it easier for an operator nowadays than what it was when I came to work, because now I can go in there and look and see. I don't have to be surprised, well, this train coming, he's got 50 cars to set off for me. I can find that out in advance and know in advance if he's going to work here. This is the circuit board for here at Hancock, okay? This is the railroad, my section of it. These are traffic levers. I have to have it turned the direction I want the train to go because I cannot get a signal if I don't have it turned in the right direction. All right, so that's traffic levers. When a train, this is number one track, and on our railroad, this section of it, our railroad runs east to west, west to east. West is the odd number, so westbound track is number one. Eastbound track is the even number, number two. This is the track that goes up to Berkeley Springs to the U.S. Silica sand plant. We service them. That's all these cars over here in this yard are for there. All right, so if we have an eastbound coming from Cumberland, he hits my circuit, the light comes on, a bell rings, okay? And the dispatcher says, I can let him go number two track. So he's on number two and I want to line him down number two. I make sure all my switches are normal so that he's not going to be crossing over. He's going to go straight. And I would throw 52 to the left, which would be this signal right here. And when I throw that, it shows me that all the switches are locked so that they cannot be moved while this train is going across there. And there's the signal. That shows me that he has a signal indication out on the signal mast. Train has a problem and we want to run another train, but we're going to run him like around him. I need to be able to throw a switch. So I take the signal away from him by telling him I'm going to take the signal away. I throw it back to normal. It goes out. But you see, everything stays locked up until we time it out. And to time it out, I have to turn this all the way to zero to run off. And when this signal runs off, this thing will tell it, and then these lights will go out, and then I can throw a switch. While they're locked, I cannot throw them.
The crossover switches at HO Tower are controlled by levers, and these levers can be very cantankerous. They're connected to switch locks, derails, and switches by rod linkage. Throwing these levers moves the rods down the length of the plant, and the tired, old equipment can sometimes put up a fight. Ginger Stanley is one of the few women operators capable of working the levers at HO. And she's not thrilled to perform a demonstration. But with a little sweet talking by yours truly, she agreed to give them and herself a little exercise. The rods are not highly maintained. No reason to expend valuable resources and time on something that's about to be replaced.
That's called the train line, and all of us on this division are hooked up to the dispatcher who is in Jacksonville. And all of us that are in towers or offices that are still open, we talk and communicate with that dispatcher on that box. The next operator, I want to make sure, first off, when I have a train by me, that he knows it's coming to him. So I can call him on the phone, but it's easier if he's sitting there just like me and he has the box just like me. And I tell the dispatcher that the train is by me. Then I make sure he knows that the train is by me by him just saying, okay, Ginge, I got that, or okay, Hancock, I got that. And I'll do the same thing with him. When he has a train westbound by him coming towards me, and I hear it, I write it on my train sheet, know it's the next train coming to me, then I say, okay, Carl, I got that. But then when we're not busy, it's a line of communication just to sit and talk.
Hancock East. Q276-8223-0912-2.
All trains will communicate to me when they're in my territory if they have problems. And then I need to decide how to transfer that to someone who needs it or get them help or fix whatever their problems are, whatever. Then I'm also in charge of this yard over here, keeping track of all the cars that we have in the yard, who they're for, how old they are, because you can't leave cars sitting around too long. You need to move them. If I have loading that needs to be moved, cars that don't belong here, where they need to go, get it arranged for them to be picked up, get the paperwork No car can move on the railroad, or no car on paper shouldn't move without having paperwork to go with it. Because you never know, like you said, about where a train might get stopped somewhere. And you need to know what's in a car, what's the car, what's it all about. And that would be part of my job. We don't have a yard master in charge of us here. We do it. You know that we have to pass tests, and there are rules, and everything has to run by rule. I make no decisions. There are rules that govern everything. And we have a book of rules. And that tells me everything I need to do and know.
I'll be forever grateful for taking the time and opportunity to spend a morning with Ginger at H.O. Tower. Later, I spent an afternoon with Jim Vargo at West Cumbo, and on several occasions spent time with Ed Carfelt at Sandpatch. These people didn't have to permit me inside and probably committed a rules infraction by doing so. I thank them for opening their doors to an inquisitive fan with a desire to learn and to document what went on inside an operator's tower before it became impossible to do so. Rejoice! All hail the operator and the interlocking tower, an icon of railroading that's come to its end.
Cheater bank for a second. Rain.